Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us today to learn about the environmental field. Our planet needs our help, and taking a degree which relates to the environment is a great way to make a difference. Today, I'll be interviewing Samantha, who has a joint honors major in Environmental and Resource Studies and Canadian Studies. Now, before we get into the details of your degree, I'll start with an easy question. What sparked your passion for the environment?
That's a great question. I think I've always been drawn to nature and animals specifically. I spent my summers as a kid collecting ladybugs in jars, and I visited Presqu'ile Provincial Park's Nature Center every year to see the turtles and the fish that they had on display. Even when I was indoors, my favorite TV shows were the ones that featured animals. I was obsessed with the Pratt Brothers TV shows. I'll admit, it wasn't the Wild Krauts, which is on TV now that I was watching, but it was their first shows, Subumufu and Krauts Creatures, that were part of my childhood. I wanted so badly to be out there in the woods with them, saving creatures too.
The Krabb Brothers certainly are great examples when it comes to inspiring youth. As you grew up, how did these childhood interests influence your decisions around your post-secondary education?
When I was in grade 12, I was pretty lost. I wanted something that would help me to protect the planet and the creatures that I loved, but I couldn't think of a degree or diploma that was right for me. I was way too squeamish to become a veterinarian, and I found science courses too challenging to become a biologist. Where I excelled was history and English, but they weren't my passion. To be honest, with course selection deadlines looming, I was quite stressed. So it was a huge relief when I discovered that Trent University had both an environmental studies program and a Canadian studies program. These disciplines helped me to learn more about how Canadians view and relate to the natural world. Better yet, there are more books, interviews, and essays than beakers and lab reports, so it matched my strengths. These degrees also helped me to study topics which interested me, such as species at risk and environmental education. It led me to realize how little the average Canadian knows about our local species and the laws that protect them. By the time I was 22, I had set aside my childhood dream of saving animals, but it was becoming clear that we needed more people like the Pratt Brothers, who could explain complex environmental concepts in a fun and accessible way.
I like how your education circled back to your childhood and led you to see a need. Since you graduated, have you been able to help fill this need for education?
Yes. Thankfully, I'm not the only person who has recognized the need for environmental education, and there are a variety of organizations who have hired me to develop and present content. Currently, I work for both Parks Canada and the Thousand Islands History Museum. My latest project, which is developing this video series, has been a real treat. I finally had the chance to have my Krabb Brother moment. I might not be on TV per se, but having the opportunity to share my passion with others through a video series is something I never thought I'd have the chance to do.
That's great. With the experience you've gained building this video series, what would you say is the best way to encourage others to care as much about the planet as you do?
I would say that the best way to motivate others is to avoid the vague tales of doom. It's important to tell people that climate change is real and that species are dying. But if it's our only message, it'll just leave people feeling sad and helpless. So be specific and enthusiastic. Share with others what you love and give simple steps that they can take, even if it's something small. Joy is infectious, and if you truly care about something, others will notice your passion and be motivated to help.
Awesome. Thank you, Samantha, for sharing your experiences with us today. It's a great reminder that there are a variety of environmental degrees and career paths out there in the arts as well as in the sciences. For our viewers, we hope that this video inspires you as you consider your options for your future studies and careers. The state of the planet is worrisome, to say the least, but the future is brighter with you in it. Thank you for joining us today.